The working poor.
The working poor.
The working poor.
The working poor.
It could be anyone.
They could be your next door neighbour.
I'm actually poor.
Is it fair?
No, it's not.
From anywhere.
It's degrading.
It could be a friend.
I want to get ahead.
I hate asking for help.
One big shock, and it could be you.
You can get sick or have a relationship breakdown.
These people are hidden.
It's like an iceberg.
Struggling.
It's a national crisis.
And at breaking point.
It's just a lose-lose situation for New Zealanders, and it's not the way we should be going.
My name is Bella Walters. I'm 58, and I work 5 days a week. I get paid $16.75.
Bella is among the working poor.
Come on, girl. I'm going to get you fed, and I've got to get off to work. There's a lot of good people out there like myself that struggle, that want to make a difference, that care.
And working hard.
And working so hard for so little, this much.
She does laundry and cleaning at an Auckland care home up to 8-hour days.
I expect a fair day's work for a fair day's pay, and that's how I've been brought up.
Her three kids have grown up and left the family home she's rented for 14 years.
If I didn't have the support from my son and my daughter, I would be out there with the homeless. That's where I'd be, because my rent is more than my wages.
Life is lean for Bella. Her budget is extremely tight, even with her kids helping out.
So how much have you got to spend?
I've got about $40. When I go grocery shopping, I be very careful about what I buy and how much I buy. I get all the reduced foods, mainly sausages, potatoes, and these are the things that I'm not supposed to be eating because of my blood pressure.
This aisle.
Milk.
So what are you supposed to be eating?
I'm supposed to be eating salads, anything without fat on it, no sugars.
Why don't you?
Because I can't afford that stuff.
This free-range chicken breast is cheap.
So, Bella, let's run through your budget for the week. How much is your rent?
$4.75.
Plus power, food and petrol comes to $655.
And how much would you earn? What are your wages every week?
$460.
That's after tax and her accommodation supplement from Wins.
$200 a week.
Okay, so that's $660, so there's $5 left over.
Yeah, that'll be about right.
Every week?
Yeah.
But Bella doesn't have much choice.
Can you live somewhere cheaper?
No, no ways. For me to go from here to a one-bedroom place, I'd be paying a bit more than what I'm paying already. So why would I move?
Oh, I see, this is broken. The hinge.
Yeah.
And she's got no buffer.
And when did you do that? How long ago?
2-3 years.
Wow, okay.
Yeah.
It's holding well.
Well, it is for now. Yeah.
You right with them, Mom?
That is what family's about, you know? Like, just sacrificing. I couldn't leave my mum behind. That's why I've only just recently moved out, so I'll always be there for Mum and make sure she gets some glasses.
I feel really bad because I should pay for my own stuff. I should be able to pay my own rent. I should be able to pay my own power. I should be able to get my own job and have the living wage so I can do this. That's what it means to me.
For people like Bella, this is the sort of thing that tips you over the balance, yeah.
Charles Waldegrave, social policy researcher.
She's living in Auckland, so she'd be paying high rent, and that is part of the definition of the working poor. You know, a society provides income stability for people, is changing.
For 35 years, Charles has made understanding poverty his priority.
We've got a rental and a housing crisis that's out of control at the moment. There's a lot more part-time and casual work, and we've got a low-wage economy that simply has to change.
Should we be worried?
I think we should be very worried, because 40% of the children who are below the poverty threshold live in households where there's at least one full-time worker in the family.
And he should know. Charles helped calculate the poverty line in 1995. Now his attention is focused on the working poor.
Charles, do we know how many people are working poor?
Well, we don't really know. And we have to know. And New Zealand has just got away for a long time with a very low wage economy. And it's biting. It's biting really hard.
So much so that workers have had enough.
We're here today to tell them that it is the government's problem.
Charles says the concept of a living wage, $20.55 an hour, will help. That's $4 higher than the current minimum wage, enough to lift many workers out of poverty.
The living wage has been set in countries like the UK and Canada and New Zealand. Australians don't really have a living wage movement of any substance because they don't need it. They're getting 32% more on average in their wages than New Zealanders.
My name is Patrick. I'm 35 years old. I'm getting $18 an hour. Per week I'm doing is 45 to 50 hours.
Patrick's a forklift driver working up to 6 days a week.
You proud you're working?
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. It's taking a bit of a toll, quite a few sacrifices just to get by.
He's just starting to get back on his feet after being homeless last year.
What got me into the situation was when me and my partner broke up. That's how I became homeless.
What was life like?
Real hard. It was a real struggle trying to survive. How am I going to eat?
What was it like sleeping in your car?
Horrible. Most nights it was sleepless nights. I couldn't sleep.
The worst thing was being separated from his five-year-old daughter.
She's the one that pulled me through, you know, in the hard times in that 6 weeks.
And then he met Alma.
Morning.
Good to see you.
Good to see you.
How was the travel over?
Oh, the travel was good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Thanks for bringing the weather for
her. Oh, not a problem.
Alma and his Rotorua-based charity Love Soup helped Patrick get a job and a roof over his head.
We're not affiliated with politicians, we're not affiliated with churches. It's just human kindness. I wanted to see how things were going, you know, how's the housing situation, and I brought a little gift for you as well.
Oh, wow.
Thank you, my man. Cheers for that.
I think he's borderline in the struggling mode. I wouldn't be surprised if he was going hungry on a regular basis.
Patrick can't afford to rent in Tauranga, so he's boarding. That plus power, food and petrol soaks up most of his weekly pay packet of $550.
And the car payment?
$89.
Your student loan?
About $40.
And then you've got to repay WINS as well?
Yeah, $30.
So there's quite a lot of debt you're paying off, isn't there?
It is. It is. It's pretty huge.
Debt is really common. If you're on low income, people actually stalk you for debt. They also get into debt to government departments because a lot of the welfare assistance is a loan.
I should be happy, but I feel like I'm not. Money's still coming out. I probably only see, 15% of the pay. But I have to stay positive, or else if I go down the wrong road, I failed my daughter.
Mm. Up next, behind the scenes. A charity filling the gap.
We just can't say no.
And their message from the front line.
I'm sick and tired of people having to wait for days for food.
Is it a crisis?
Kiwi families are struggling, up and down the country. Filling the gap in Christchurch.
Hi, how you going?
Good, how are you?
The first year we did about 11,500 food parcels.
Husband and wife team, Nikki and Kerry.
The operation of 0800 Hungary is to avoid the embarrassment.
When people call, they always pick up.
The need is horrendous sometimes.
They're worried at the number of workers in need.
It's like an iceberg. There's only one third of it showing and there's two thirds of it sitting underground.
So what's the biggest box you do?
This box here is the biggest box. It's designed for a family of five plus. It is quite heavy. Minimum wage. It's not a livable wage, and if you do take one thing out of that family that does cause a hiccup, that's a big, big issue for them.
And what's in there?
There's a lot of yogurt in there. Yeah? When you go into these homes and they turn around and say, my child was sick, then the working person ended up sick, so that means that income's immediately cut.
How much would this pile of food cost?
I would estimate at least at $200.
And where does the food come from?
It's all donated. It's all
from
donated
who?
From the manufacturers. We're the hunter-gatherers. We have recovered, on an estimate, over $33 million worth of food in the last 17 years.
$33 million worth of food, close to expiry, that was heading for the dump.
So what do you think that says about our food systems?
There's a lot of waste. It's being able to capture it and bring it in and then present it.
And that's up to a small army of volunteers.
It's a big operation to run this. We're doing 250 food parcels a week. You're looking at 1,000 people that are actually getting food.
Volunteers come, pack, load, and they're off.
You've got a lot of people in here today.
I know, it's fantastic.
Yeah, lots of volunteers.
Couldn't do without them.
People got to eat. There's so many people out there struggling.
It makes you kind of cry, really, when you know what's going on out there, eh?
0800 Hungry, New Zealand's largest food bank, delivers, and that's the hard bit.
The weakness is from there to there. It's getting the food from those shelves out to the people that actually need it, yeah.
Often they get behind the wheel themselves.
Do you think you're reaching different types of people because you're delivering?
I think so. It's less embarrassing. That's always that stigma when you're turning around and having to face people.
You can't judge. You can turn up at a nice house, nice furniture, nice car, and you think, why do they need a food parcel? But you don't know that the business hasn't fallen over in recent times.
Time's over there.
For Gary, it was a marriage breakup.
G'day.
Hi, how are
Thank you?
I'm Nikki.
How are you? How are you going?
Yeah,
you
all right, afternoon. I've got it. I'm perfectly balanced at the moment. Yeah, it's a lot of food, hey?
Yes.
So, Gary, what's the situation? Why do you need this today?
I had money stolen out of my account, and it's just really put me behind. I hate asking for help, and even if you look around, you know, it's like, you know, you don't need it, but I do. I've got four kids half the time, and
four.
I just... Four kids. Yeah, so we separated 3 years ago.
Are you working?
I am, yes, yep, I am. So, yeah, I really want to get back on top, but it's just, yeah, at the moment I'm struggling, so, yeah.
Well, you're not alone, Gary.
Yeah.
Is that unusual?
No, it's not. And you're hearing more and more and more of it.
Hi.
Hi. How are you, Erin?
Thank you.
Good. Just down here?
Yeah, just down here. Thank you very much. It's awesome.
So who's the cake for?
My twin sons, they turned 14 today, and because of obviously financial situations, I don't get to buy them birthday present this year again.
Erin's a cleaner. She's had to reduce work hours because of back pain.
It's heartbreaking, real heartbreaking, because I can't do what I need to for the kids.
It's disheartening. It never used to be like that. The harder you work, the easier life is meant to be, but it's not.
Hi, how are you going?
Good, how are you? There we are. Lots of little goodies.
Louise and her husband both work.
Well, he's contract and I'm casual, so I just kind of work where I can. And
what are you guys making every week?
Anywhere between probably 400 and 700, I'm not too sure.
Does that make it hard to plan?
Yeah, it does.
People are grappling with how we address this.
Social Development Minister Carmel Cipollone.
Is it a crisis?
We have been going through a housing crisis for quite some time, and the housing crisis has...
It's creating a social crisis.
The housing crisis is to blame for a lot of what we're seeing in terms of the social issues that are arising.
The government wants to build 100,000 affordable houses over the next decade.
$600,000, $650,000 for a house in Auckland, that's just not affordable.
No, it's not. And so we as a government need to look at the areas that we can assist with that. And we have been very proactive with respect to that already, but that doesn't mean that there's not more to do.
Is it going to get worse before it gets better?
Look, we can't fix everything immediately. We've already put some of the measures into place.
A raft of new measures, including help with the winter power bill, come into force today. relief for some working families, but it's not an easy fix.
It's a complex relationship between the labour market and the welfare system, the tax and benefit system of trying to get everyone up to a level.
A level Charles says should be $20.55, the living wage.
I think it's part of the answer, for sure. You know, we as a government had said coming in to this before the election that we would be committed to rolling it out across the public sector, and now we've announced recently that we'll do that, and hopefully that will have an impact.
But it's core outside. Workers, isn't it? What about contractors?
It's core workers, but I think that the idea down the track is then we'll look at that next stage.
I think businesses need to think ethically about this. If you can't afford to pay people adequately, then really, should you be in business?
It's a question Dan Mickelson took seriously when becoming a boss.
I just think that people should be able to work a job and have a life outside of that.
Giving the living wage in his bike cafe has benefits.
The quality of service, the engagement of the staff.
It pays off.
Yeah, well, I believe it does.
And for Audrey, the step up from her previous minimum wage job has been life-changing.
I don't have to worry about my rent and my bills. I've got some money to save at the end of the week.
How does it feel coming to work for an employer who's happy to pay the living wage?
Yeah, you know, it makes me feel so valued.
What the research shows is you reduce absenteeism, you have higher motivation, therefore you get higher productivity.
Do you think we'll ever have a future where there are no working poor?
Well, I'd love to think of that sort of utopia.
It has been pretty chilly.
I can't afford the heater to be on.
We have allowed poverty just to get out of hand and stop any politicking on this at all and just solve this problem.
It's values, says Charles, about whether hard workers like Bella and Patrick should have to rely on charity to fill the gap.
I'm just worried about the generation coming through, my muckles. What's this world going to be really like for them?
Will it be a struggle even if they're working, or will it be a place some wishes come true?
I wish that our communities could take care of our communities.
I wish the working poor had more financial security.
I wish for everyone around New Zealand to get the living wage.
I wish to save up and buy my own place.
Thank you.
Well, if you want to help out or need more information, go to our Facebook page, Sunday TVNZ.